cost of production.
Right.
And there was talk in 2015 of 200 being that bottom for a lot of miners. Again, in this $3,500 to $4,500 range.
$200.
In 2015.
That was the cost to mine one Bitcoin.
Yes.
For the servers, the electricity, all of it.
The rent, all of that.
Okay.
And so that was what we based on in 2015, was $200.
Right.
Here we are in 2018 having the same conversation, different price range, but with people saying, okay, you know, miners are going to go offline, anything below these prices.
And so that's very interesting because people don't really understand that if the mining prices are too high to what the cost is, remember, as less miners are mining the cryptocurrency, it becomes cheaper and cheaper to mine it. Now, it's going to obviously be less secure because there's less people backing up the network. But at the same time, you know, we've seen Bitcoin, like they've talked about in the past, you know, go down to 200, and it still was a secure network. And it's very, very easy for miners to adjust. And think about it, a lot of these miners have made long-term capital investments, and they're not just going to shut down and close down shop. I mean, a lot of them might reduce their mining production and reduce their expenses and wait for the prices to rebound to scale up their operation. But long-term, they're not going to go away. And the bottom, like I said, I don't think it's very hard. You know, cryptocurrencies is a completely new asset class. So I know there's a lot of experts that come on the news and try to give you pricing, but there really is no way. It is a speculative asset. It's very hard to look at any kind of fundamentals to price it. But I would say it's the same thing with the stock market. You know, PE ratios in the stock market, they're all over the place. You know, Amazon has one of the craziest PE ratios, but people still buy it because of, you know, what they believe in. And I think it's something similar to cryptos where it's going to be hard to price it, but there is a history behind it. And I do feel like the people that were buying the dip in 2012 or 13, it was riskier back then. There's just such a large network of people on Bitcoin, for example, where I don't see it going to zero. It hasn't happened. And in fact, if you study the graph and you study the history of cryptocurrencies, it always rebounds. And it sometimes takes a year or two, but when it rebounds much, much higher. And so if you've already gotten wiped out, you know, it is unfortunate, but there is an opportunity to buy at these low prices. And the best thing you can do if you don't feel comfortable buying is just continue to watch this market. And I would definitely consider making some sort of purchase, or if you've been crushed, possibly, I mean, if you're really, really hurting, maybe it is a good idea to sell and look to buy back in when prices are either lower or when you feel like the market is coming back. But that's really hard to do. For me, I'm just a long-term holder, so I just haven't sold. I just keep buying and I just keep accumulating. And it does suck because I'm down probably now 40, 50% on my investment. So I'm probably negative over $10,000 on crypto, but it's okay. Like, I don't care because I still think it's a good long-term investment. And if you see the kind of returns people were getting in 2017, if that happens in 2020 or 21, obviously I'm okay with it. And long-term, I just do not like the government, how they can print infinite money and how the banking system works. So for me, it's more of a it's charity in a way for me. I would rather invest in this infrastructure that doesn't allow central governments to just print a bunch of money and for bankers to basically have banking cartels that, you know, we give them their money, they go lend it out times 10, and then, you know, they keep all the profits. So in a way, this is still something I believe in, and that's why I'm willing to take that risk. If you don't believe in that, it's fine. Just continue to watch the market, and maybe when you change your mind, you'd be more interested. But yeah, if you're just trying to speculate, I don't know if that's a good idea. It's better to speculate on stocks or something a little more stable. Let me know what you guys think about this, and I will talk to you soon.